everyone, welcome to yet another video from my channel. In this video, I'm going to be talking to you about how you could use VLOOKUP, LOOKUP and the newly introduced XLOOKUP as an alternative to IF function. Let's say I'm talking about modeling for a tax problem and I have 7 slabs. And if an income falls under a particular slab, I have to figure out which slab it falls in, what's the applicable tax rate, and then calculate the tax. So if I'm doing it with if function, there are so many levels of nested if. Is there a smarter way to do it? Of course, yes. And that's what we're going to learn now. Before I explain this, let me first explain the problem to you, especially for those of you who do not understand how taxation works. In a lot of countries, for taxes, we have slabs. So depending upon in which category your income falls in, you have different tax rates applicable. So in this case, let's say I'm using the Indian tax slab. So if your income is between 0 to 250,000, you pay no tax. If your income is, let's say, above 500,000, then for the first 500,000, you pay 12,500, which is basically 500,000 minus 250,000 times 5%. So on the first 500,000, you pay 12,500. And on the rebalance income, you pay 10% tax. So in this case, for example, if the income is 600,000, on the first 500,000, I paid 12,500. The balance amount is 600,000 minus 500,000. That's 100,000. So 100,000 times 10%, that's 10,000. So 10,000 plus 12,500 gives me 22,500. If the income was, let's say, 1.6 million instead, then what would have happened? For the first 1.5 million, I would have paid 187,500. And for the balance 100,000, I'll be paying 30% tax. So that's going to be 217,500. This is how the problem works. So how do we use a VLOOKUP? If my income is 1.6 million, that 1.6 million is not even there in the slabs. How can I make Excel figure out what is the applicable tax rate for it? This is where the approximate option in VLOOKUP comes in handy. Many of you might have tilted wondering, you know, why would I ever use an approximate match? But this is one example where you can use it. So how is this going to work? Let me show you. I'll change our number back to 600,000. So firstly, we want to figure out what is the tax applicable up to previous slab. To do that, you start with VLOOKUP. The lookup value is going to be our income. You select that. Comma. Then where are we looking at for the lookup values? We are going to select this full table. And once we select the table, what we want here, we want tax up to previous slab, and that's in the third column of our table. So let's mention that, comma 3. Now, naturally, you may be tended to type comma 0 at the end if you have been somebody who's been using VLOOKUP, but that's not what we're going to do here. Here, I'll leave it as it is, or you could alternatively type comma 1, which is the default value, or you can also leave it as it is. And you notice that VLOOKUP function fetches me the tax for the previous slab. How did it do it? Because 600,000 is not even there in this list. How did this just figure that out? What VLOOKUP does when you use an approximate match is that it looks at the first column and it assumes that your first column is in ascending order, right? So this is not going to work if your first column is not in ascending order. So does it care about what's there in the middle column? Not at all. It only reads things from the first column. And what it knows is that, you know, the 600,000 comes before 750,000. That's something that it knows. And accordingly, it picks up whatever is the value applicable to the previous slab, which is the 500,000 slab. So using this approximate option, we can pretty much get everything here. So let me try to do that for other items as well. So what is the income falling in current slab? That's going to be my income minus the starting value of the first slab, right? So that's going to be 600,000 minus VLOOKUP for the same 600,000 in this table and pull up the data that's there in the first column. That's 100,000. And to get the tax rate, I'll just copy paste this formula. And tax rate is in the fourth column. So in the column index position, I'll put it as comma 4. It comes to 0.1. I'll just change the formatting. Shift Control 5 is the format, or the shortcut key to change the format into percentage. Now we've got that. So my tax amount is pretty simple now. It's going to be 12,500 plus 100,000 is the income falling in this slab times 10%. What's the best part about using VLOOKUP as an alternative to IF function? The best part is tomorrow, let's say the slab changes. Let's say we've been introduced to a new slab where perhaps I have something like this. 1,250,000 to let's say I have something like 1.5 million, and let's say 1.5 million to 2 million becomes a new slab. That's 2 times 10 power 6. And let's say 2 million onwards and above 2 million, there's a new slab. Let's say this is 30% and this is 35. So now that I've introduced one more slab, let's see what happens if we change our income. If you look at our if function, it's probably getting linked to wrong places. So if I change my income to something like 1.6 million, let's say, or I'll just put it as 1.6 times 10 to the power 6. You notice that our if function has gone for a toss because with introducing new rows and other things, it's not getting linked correctly. So I'll have to re-edit the entire formula, add one more level of nesting and change the formula. Whereas our VLOOKUP is easily scaled up now, right? That's one of the greatest advantages of working with VLOOKUP over if function. Now, because we are using approximate match, we could have also worked with the lookup function. So let me use a lookup function here. So equals lookup, you specify the lookup value. Then you specify in which column are you looking up for the data. And once you specify that, you can specify in which column is the result. And my result is in the previous slab. And I'll close it. I'll take it back to the 600,000 example we had. So I got the same 12,500. If you are looking at income falling in current slab, what would that be? So that's going to be 600,000 minus the lookup value, or rather the income minus the lookup value. And in this case, I don't need to specify the lookup vector because my lookup vector and the result vector are same. So I don't actually need this. And it's going to give me that 100,000. And as far as the tax that's applicable to the slab is concerned, so same, look for 600,000 in this lookup vector, and the result we want is the tax rate. So I'll just change the reference cell here. Shift Control 5 to get that in, get the tax rate in percentage format, and same formula, right? So as you can see here, you could have used lookup function or a VLOOKUP when you're using approximate match. But both VLOOKUP and lookup function suffer from one limitation, which is that it expects this data to be in ascending order. Normally, that's how we would maintain our file. So no doubt, there is no problem with that. But occasionally, people may sort the data and they may keep it in descending order. So this is where XLOOKUP can come in handy. But one thing you need to know is that XLOOKUP as on date, which is May 2020, is available only for Office 365 users. You can also access it from Office Online, or alternatively, if you're using Zoho Office, XLOOKUP is available in that too. But before I use XLOOKUP, one thing we need to know is that XLOOKUP by default assumes that we are looking for accurate match. But in this case, we are looking for approximate match. So let's give the XLOOKUP function XLOOKUP. It works more or less on the lines of lookup function. So XLOOKUP, first you specify the lookup value. Then you specify where you're looking for the data. That's in the previous slab. I mean, tax up to previous slab. That's what I'm looking for. And what if the data is not found? Well, we are looking for approximate match. So I'll ignore this part. And in approximate match, what kind of match are we looking at? If the value matches, get me the value for that. Otherwise, I want tax for the previous slab. So look for exact match or smaller. That's minus one. Now this gives us 12,500. Let me copy and paste it. For the income falling in the previous slab, that's going to be my income number minus XLOOKUP. But what we want to pull up is the lower end. not the tax slab. So XLOOKUP for this C5 and pull out the data from the lower end. That's 100,000. And the tax for the current slab is going to be, again, I'll copy paste this formula and we're going to say the lookup vector, look for 600,000 in the lower end section, and the lookup vector is the tax rate. You specify that. Again, I'll change the percentage formula. It works. And the best part about XLOOKUP is that XLOOKUP can handle even if our data is sorted in descending order. Let me just copy paste some of these values, because these formulas go for a toss when data is in ascending order, or rather when the data is in descending order. So let me select this. I'll go to data, sort, sort by lower end in descending order, largest to smallest. So if you look at it, VLOOKUP is giving us wrong answers. I mean, it's not able to produce answers. If function is worse, it's giving us wrong answers. 517,500 as a tax amount. That's ridiculously high. But XLOOKUP is solid here. It still gives us the correct answer, right? So eventually, as we all get to use XLOOKUP, I would say XLOOKUP is probably the best alternative here. But until then, you can also consider using VLOOKUP or the lookup functions. I hope you found this video useful. To keep getting much more information, much more better ways of working with Excel, please subscribe to this channel. And also please spread the knowledge by sharing this video. Thank you. Thank you very much.